Managing your finances such as equity or debt can be a hassle given the tasks you perform every day. Thankfully, the Depository Act of 1996 has made it easier for everyone to manage their financial securities in a few clicks. Instead of receiving physical copies of shares or other securities, a DMAT account helps you to leverage the benefits of an online trading platform where you hold your financial security on a standardized electronic system. According to the Securities Exchange Board of India, a DMAT account is mandatory for anyone trading in financial securities. When it comes to investing in the stock market, opening DMAT account is a prerequisite. And if you are a new investor, having queries regarding DMAT account is normal. Hi guys, this is Simran from ClearTax, and in today's video, we will try to answer all your questions regarding DMAT account. But before we begin, do not forget to press the bell icon and like, share and subscribe to our channel for more updates. So in the first segment of the video, I'll be talking about what a DMAT account is, what are its types and what are the key elements of a DMAT account. For any specific topic, you can refer to the timestamps mentioned in the description box below. So what are we waiting for? Let's begin.
What is a DMAT account? A DMAT account or dematerialized account provides the facility of holding shares and securities in an electronic format. During online trading, shares are bought and held in a DMAT account, thus facilitating easy trade for the users. A DMAT account holds all the investments an individual makes in shares, government securities, exchange-traded funds, bonds, and mutual funds in one place. There are two types of DMAT accounts: repatriable DMAT account and non-repatriable DMAT account. Repatriable funds are deposited in a separate bank account known as the non-resident external account, also known as the NRE account. Repatriable funds are those funds which can be transferred abroad. The investments made from these funds are maintained in the repatriable DMAT account. On the other hand, non-repatriable funds which cannot be taken or transferred abroad are deposited in a different bank account known as the non-resident ordinary account, also known as the NRO account. The non-repatriable DMAT account holds the investments made from non-repatriable funds. Money can be easily transferred from an NRE to an NRO account. However, once the transfer is made, the repatriability is lost and the money cannot be transferred back to the NRE account. Key elements of a DMAT account. There are four key elements. The first one is depository. There are two authorized depositories operating in India, that is, Central Depository of Securities Limited and National Depository of Securities Limited. These two institutions electronically hold pre-verified shares. The second one is Depository Participant, also known as the DP. Any financial institution that is registered under SEBI can act as an agent of the depository and conduct transactions for the investor. Any depository service has to be channeled through the DP. A DP can be a financial institution, a scheduled commercial bank, a foreign bank operating in India, a stock broker, a clearing house, a state financial corporation, a share transfer agent, a non-banking financial company, etc. SEBI assigns every DP a unique code. The third one is investor. The investor is the individual who is the owner of the securities. In this case, the person holding the DMAT account is the investor. The fourth and the last one is unique ID. Every DMAT account has a unique 16-digit identification number which ensures smooth and transparent processing of securities.
Now that you know the basics of a DMAT account, you may be inclined towards opening a DMAT account. So guys, in this segment, I'll be talking about how to open a DMAT account and what is the eligibility of an investor to open a DMAT account. Well, conveniently enough, opening a DMAT account is easy. It can be done in two ways, offline and online. Let's take a look at how to open a DMAT account offline.
How to open a DMAT account? The first step is select a depository participant. Once you've compared the services and benefits offered by different DPs, you can finalize the most suitable DP for your needs. The second step is fill out the application form. You will need to fill out an application form for opening a new DMAT account. Along with this, you will need to submit a list of KYC documents such as identity proof, address proof, PAN card, bank details, and your personal details. The third step is the verification process. You will be given a list of rules and regulations to ensure ethical and legal trading and to clear any doubts you may have regarding holding a DMAT account and the different functions it serves. The DP will conduct an in-person verification of you and your KYC documents. You will have to pay any necessary fee associated with opening a DMAT account. The fee depends on the existing policy of the DP, and the fee varies from DP to DP. The fourth and the last step is the final approval. Once your documents are verified and the final formalities are completed, your new DMAT account will be opened. You will also be given the unique identification number for your account.
Well, that was easy, but hold on, there is a more convenient way of opening a DMAT account. Equipped with only a computer, laptop, tab or smartphone, you can open your DMAT account in just a few minutes. So let's see how.
How to open a DMAT account online. The first step is head to the official website of your preferred depository participant. The second step is fill out the simple lead form asking for your name, phone number and city of residence. You will then receive an OTP on your registered mobile number. Enter the OTP to get to the next form. Fill in your KYC details such as date of birth, PAN card details, contact details and bank account details. Your DMAT account is now open. You will receive details such as DMAT account number on your email and phone. An investor can have multiple DMAT accounts. These accounts can be with the same depository participant or with different DPs. As long as the investor can provide the required KYC details for all applications, they can open multiple DMAT accounts. Eligibility of investor. Any registered resident of India with the necessary documentation to prove it can open a DMAT account in India. With certain restrictions under SEBI, even non-resident Indians can open a DMAT account. A DMAT account can have up to 3 account holders, that is 2 joint account holders and 1 main account holder. Just like with banks, there is a provision to nominate a beneficiary in case of death. In case of joint account holders, each account holder is encouraged to nominate a beneficiary. The nominee can be changed or updated as per the wishes of the account holder.
I think that was actually very convenient. So now, coming to the next and the final segment, I'll be talking about how you can link your bank account with a DMAT account, and following that, I'll be talking about two ways to transfer shares from one DMAT account to another. So without any further ado, let's begin with this segment. When it comes to linking a bank account with a DMAT or trading account, it is important to know that while the basic process may remain the same, there are certain details that may vary from one bank account to another. It is possible to link one primary account and two secondary accounts. The primary account will be used to process all the payouts, while the secondary accounts may be used to process the pay-ins. Here are the steps you should follow to link your bank account with a DMAT account.
How to link a bank account with a DMAT account? The first step is visit the website of the bank where the account is held. Fill in the required form for the process to be initiated. The second step is in certain cases, one may be required to take a printout of the filled form and send it to an address provided by the bank where the account is held. The last step is, in order to add a secondary account, additional proof of the secondary bank account is required. A cancelled and personalized check, a bank passbook statement or a self-assessed bank statement can all be offered as document of proof. After following all these steps, your bank account will be linked to your DMAT account.
Well, now that you know how to link your bank account with a DMAT account, let's come to the last topic of this segment, that is transferring shares from one DMAT account to another. The transfer can be done in two ways, either by manual transfer or by online transfer. So let's start with the offline procedure first.
Manual or offline transfer of shares. The first step is record the names of the shares that are to be transferred. Additionally, the ISIN number has to be recorded as well, wherein the ISIN or the International Securities Identification Number is a 12-digit code required to identify securities such as funds, equities, bonds, stocks, debts, and more. It is essential to correctly enter the ISIN number as the transactions will be processed based on it. The second step is the target client ID has to be recorded. It is a 16-character code which includes the ID of the client and the ID of the depository participant. The third step is an important step as it involves the selection of the method of transfer. If the mode of transfer is an intra-depository or an off-market transfer, then the column titled off-market transfer has to be selected. If the mode of transfer is inter-depository, then the inter-depository column should be selected. It is important to be cautious when selecting this option. Once the DIS slip has been filled in, there are a few final steps that needs to be taken. The fourth step is the filled in and signed DIS slip must be submitted to the account holder's existing broker. The fifth step is the acknowledgement receipt for the DIS slip must be collected from the broker. It will take between 3 to 5 business days for the existing broker to transfer the required shares from the old DMAT account and for the new broker to receive the shares in the new account. The current broker may apply a few charges for this procedure and the rates vary from one broker to another.
If an online transfer of shares is being considered, it can be simply done using CDSL. The account holder is required to visit the CDSL website and get themselves registered. Once that is done, the form has to be submitted to the depository participant. After the DP has completed the verification process, the account holder will then be allowed to make their own future transfers. These are the steps that need to be followed for an online transfer.
Now coming to online transfer of shares. The first step is, once the CDSL website has been accessed, the register online link has to be selected. The next step is to fill in the form with the required details. The third step is, once the form has been filled in, the option to print form has to be selected. After the form has been printed, it will be transferred to the account holder's DP. Step 4. After the DP has finished the verification process of the form, a password will be sent to the account holder's email ID. The last step is, using the provided password, the account holder can log in and begin transferring the required shares.
Well, this was it for today's video. Let us know what you think about the video and comment below if you have any doubts. We will try to reply to it as soon as we can. Stay tuned to our channel for more informative videos like these. Till then, goodbye and take care.